All right, hey there, Rivet crew. Happy Friday. We made it through another week. Today's class, first off, for our CrossFit members, we're going to be starting off the class with some overhead squat work, right? We have overhead squats in the main workout today, so we're going to work on technique and positioning in the first part. We're doing a 10-minute EMOM, right? Every minute, another minute. We're going to be performing one power snatch and one tempo overhead squat. Power snatch, of course, is in there to help us practice for getting that bar up into position for our overhead squats in the workout. And then our tempo overhead squat, more importantly, that is going to help us, you know, spend some time under tension and help us work on technique and positioning in the overhead squat. A lot of us tend to struggle with that movement, right? It takes a lot of flexibility, balance, stability. And no matter what your issue is, you know, whether it's not being able to punch up in the bar continually, maybe your elbows don't stay locked down, maybe your heels are lifting, whatever it is, this time under tension, this tempo overhead squat will help fix that. So our tempo work today, right? We're gonna stay on the lighter side. We'll try and build up to something that's slightly challenging for us, as long as we're maintaining good technique and good positioning. What we're looking for today in our tempo work is we're gonna snatch that bar up, and once it's over there, we're going to take a full 5 seconds down, a full 5 second pause at the bottom, 5 seconds back up. The entire time, we are focusing on punching up into the bar, right? Active shoulders, push that bar toward the ceiling. And then we're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In that bottom position, we're hanging out at the bottom for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're standing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just like that, right? That's kind of tough, even with this training bar right there for me. Time under tension, we'll do a power snatch and a tempo squat like that every minute for 10 minutes. And then everybody, really nice, very quick, effective couplet today. We're rowing for calories, and then we're doing those aforementioned overhead squats. Descending grab scheme, 27 of each, 21 of each, 15 of each, 9 of each, and you're done. Should be about 6 to maybe 10 minutes or so on the workout today, so kind of quick, 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 go, go, go. Men and women will row the same amount of calories today. Our Fit 30 athletes, of course, will be using a dumbbell. We'll be doing overhead lunges instead of the overhead squats. But other than that, everybody's doing the same workout. A couple things to think about. So we're talking about punching and we're talking about tempo today. So obviously we're doing the tempo work prior to the workout. And then, like I said, we're doing overhead squats and snatches for that matter. We're always focusing on punching the bar up and towards the ceiling, right? You want to keep those shoulders active. You want to keep those elbows locked out. We literally want to punch the bar up. Some of those same things apply to the rower, which we're doing today. So tempo, very important aspect of rowing is the tempo, right? We should have a fast drive and a slightly slower recovery. If you don't know what I'm talking about, when we're on the rower, right, the active part where we're actually driving back, this is called the drive, right? And then this, going back up to the calves, is called the recovery. Ideally, we kind of want a 1-to-2 ratio there, right? If I had to put a time on it, I'd say about a 1 second drive, and then about a 2 second recovery. 1 second drive, 2 second recovery. 1 second drive, right? The main point here is the recovery should be just that. We should slow that down a little bit. That gives us a chance to just kind of catch our breath for a moment, making sure we're getting ourselves into a really good position for that next drive, and go. 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1. You get the idea. And then the punch on the rower, right? We talked about punching up on the bar for overhead squats. When we get to that finish on the rower, we want to punch those arms forward and let our hands lead us back up. This tends to put us into a good position, right? We want heels down, space between the heels and the seat. We want to have relatively vertical shins, leaning slightly forward, right? And one of the ways we get into that position is punching those hands away from the chest as soon as you finish your stroke and letting your hands lead you back up there. All right? Coaching tips for the day. There you go. Have fun with this, guys. We're going fast and furious. Finishing up the week with a nice, short, sweet couplet to get it done. Talk to you later.